Hi guys, how are you guys doing? I hope you're all well. In this video, I'm going to be talking to you about some things to consider when you're working with interpreters. These points are very important and very helpful for an effective session with a client when you have to use an interpreter. I have been a social worker for a while. I've worked with asylum seekers, I've worked in domestic violence, I've worked in various fields, and every time I've always worked with someone from a culturally and linguistically diverse background. So, and a lot of the time, not all of them can speak English fluently. So having the option of possibly having an interpreter is always beneficial. In saying that, having an interpreter adds another layer of complexity to the work that you're doing. So it's important to be aware of these things so that the session can run as smoothly as possible. The first thing that I would recommend if you're going to be working with an interpreter and supporting a client is, before you go in with the interpreter to go and see the client, you need to do a bit of a briefing with the interpreter. And these points that I'm going to share is what needs to be covered in that briefing to ensure that the interpreter does their job really effectively. There's a lot of issues that can arise with having interpreters. Sometimes interpreters' emotions can come into the whole thing. Sometimes they can get frustrated with clients, and sometimes even though you don't understand what they're saying, you can tell that they're getting frustrated with the client because of what the client might be saying. Sometimes as well, the interpreter might know the client because they're all from the same cultural background, and interpreter might not be aware that if there's a conflict of interest, that's an issue and we need to do something about it, or they might not know that they need to bring your attention to that. So those are the things that we'll be looking at in those points that I'm going to share with you. So the first thing that I would say you need to talk to the interpreter about is who you are. What is your role? So currently I'm a child protection worker. So if I met an interpreter, I would tell them that I'm a child protection worker, this is what I do, and this is my role with this particular family. I will ask them what they know about child protection workers. They might already have an understanding, or they might be new. The second thing that I will talk about is I'll give them a brief background on the family that I'm going to be having a session with, just so they have a bit of an understanding around who they are and what's happening there. I would also let them know what the aim is of the session that I'm about to have with the client. So I'll let them know if I'm just doing an assessment, I'll let them know I'm just assessing this family because there's some safety concerns or whatever that looks like. And then I'll lay some ground rules. So some of the ground rules will be confidentiality. You know, I don't know what interpreters know about confidentiality. Do they know that everything that we say remains in the room? That's something that I will talk to them about. The other thing will be the thing that I spoke about regarding emotions. I'll make it clear that their job there is strictly to interpret, nothing else. So regardless of how they may be feeling about something that is not relevant to the conversation, they need to stick to the conversation and strictly interpret what I say and what the client might be saying. The other thing that I'll make clear is if there's anything that I say that I say too quickly, or if my sentences are too long, they need to bring my attention to that so that I can slow it down and make it easier. And then the final thing that I would mention is the interpreter cannot have any other conversations with the client within the session besides interpreting everything that I'm saying or interpreting everything that the client is saying. This way, the whole emotions thing is not a problem and the client doesn't get confused. I would also let the interpreter know that just in case we get to the place where we're having the session, whether it's a client's home or my office or wherever it is, if there's any conflict of interest issues, to let me know, and I will explain what conflict of interest looks like to the interpreter as well. Those are the points that I will cover with an interpreter before I go into a session with them. I hope you guys have found this video helpful. If you have, make sure you give it a thumbs up. Subscribe if you haven't already. And yes, I'll see you in my next video. Take care, guys. Bye. Don't forget to turn on your notification bell, that way you'll be notified every time I upload a video.